Good evening, Internet, and welcome to Top Shift Live, or Top Shift 80-something or other. It's getting that bad, I kind of lost count. But the good news is, right at this moment in time, I have got myself my ship ready. Well, almost ready. I think we've got to make one last trip to over to Xenon's in order to get this ship sorted. So what we're going to do is just have a quick check on the mission board, see if there's anything there that we can use. Tonight's drink is a double Jack Daniels. I repeat, a double Jack Daniels, which is very bracing. Nope. We've got no cargo rack, we've got no shields. Very good job, but not going where I need it to go. So, on that note, let's leave. We are in the Sidewinder. We just need to downgrade the power plant so that we've got that little bit extra range. And I should have enough credits to be able to handle it. And just, of course, as I leave, landing gear retracted. A massive T9 comes in. Have a quick look at that. And there's not any slowdown in the frame rate. That's absolutely fantastic. Right. And we're away. So, where to, I hear you cry? Well, no point scanning me, because I've got no cargo space to scan. And yeah. Go ahead. And up we go. Oh, of course, it would be blocked by the planet of Leasty itself. Super Cruise. Oh, does anybody want to slow me down anymore? Never mind. Well, we do have several things to talk about while we discuss a lot of the... or we fly about the old worlds and then start a course off to the first marker. Now, the first thing that needs to be talked about this... tonight is the progress that people have been making with the Formidine Rift. This, for those of you who do not know, the Formidine Rift is the puzzle that was started off in Drew Wagar's premonition book. Now, there are literally hundreds of people out there in the black of space scouring planets. Absolute nutters, the lot of them, but you've got to like them. And they have been making progress. In fact, a new base was discovered today, and at each of these bases there is a three or four relay beacons, which gives a little bit more plot. About what's been happening with what has been discovered as the Dynasty Expedition. Now, four bases so far. Now, Drew has left a couple of hints. We reckon for each of the expeditions, of which there are three, one out to the Rift, and another two closer to the centre of the galaxy. If there are four bases, because he's hinted at something about the Greek alphabet, and so so far we've had a Delta, Alpha, and Beta, which means that there's might be Gamma bases as well for each of them. So, well, at least the fuel scoop works. That's what we want. Right, Xeon's itself. So yes, they've managed to discover so far two beta bases, two alpha bases, and a gamma base. Oh no, a delta base. So it does imply that there are quite a few others still to discover out there. And this, they're about 10,000 light years away from the bubble. So this is not a minor thing to have jumped all the way out there. But Kanin are out there. Obviously, the children of Raxler are out there. And it's a fascinating... I mean, even though I'm down here in the bubble, it's a fascinating thing to follow on the forums. It's just nice to see that everybody's galvanizing around a common problem instead of a whole load of, the usual. This seems to be unique because we don't seem to have any griefers going out there trying to spoil it, as opposed to Xenohenge, which the Guardian expedition does seem to be hitting a little bit of a snag with, how should we put this, commanders are out for a bit of fun. One of the things that does seem to be happening is that, you know, easy prey for some of the more advanced gankers out there. So, word of warning, if you're going to head out to work on the Xenohenge, then flyer beware. Be very, very careful when flying in open. So far, these two threads do seem to be igniting a whole load of extra interest in the game, and that is not a bad thing. As far as the actual interdictions with these flower ships, which everyone is assuming is a Thargoid, well, that seems to be it. We seem to be getting interdictions, but nothing else. There's no way to communicate with them. They don't respond to hails. They don't respond to honks. They don't respond to being shot at. They just fly off. Now, I went over last week about my little particular theory that these aliens are after a certain thing. They're looking for something that we don't have yet. But they do seem to be looking for people who have had some interaction with the unknown artifacts. Now, I've never had any interaction with the unknown artifacts, and the issue that I've had, I've been told that you've got to have at least carried them at once, as if you're tainted. But I'll deal with that on my other account, because my vulture is down at Mayor at the moment, and a community goal has just started, which will involve the unknown artifacts. So I will be flying. Whoa! Oh, hang on a sec. Contacts. Quest docking. Oh, that was lucky. One thing, of course, is that so careful with lowering their landing gear here. Lowering the landing gear is B, down arrow. Boost is B. I see no problem with that whatsoever. So what we're going to do here is we're going to line up and hopefully they will have the power plant that I'm after, which I think it's just a 2D power plant, mostly because I want to have a range of about 16 light years. My other ship, of course, is my trading Cobra. Now, I have downgraded that incredibly so that I can... So that I, when it can actually get out there, it's not going to cost me as much to get the ship transferred. Because one thing that I did check is that out in Colonia, you can't buy the Cobra Mark III. Not at Jack's station, which I was quite surprised about. Neat Jack Daniels. Whoa. Anyway, so here we have the shiny Sidewinder, or the silver Sidewinder, whichever one you wish to call. Makes me a nice, easy target to look at, I think. So, do they have the reactor that I'm after? They do. And as you can see, I have just enough space to get the... I've got just enough power to manage. So, that's it. Now, I've decided to change the guns on this one to from real guns back to multi-cannons. Now, the reason for this? Stealth, effectively. I found out that the multi-cannons themselves, the real guns themselves, even when you're not using them, they just generate so much heat that you would just show up bright on someone's scanners. With this ship, it would be a perfect smuggling ship, I think, it would be an absolute perfect smuggling ship if we had the same kind of cargo capacity that, unfortunately, my fuel scoop's using up. So, that is us already. So, where to go? Allow me to show you. Eventually. Right, so as you can see, we are here. If we pull out and pull out, we will see that this is the place we want to go to. Now, I am a little bit concerned about moving between these two because it does seem quite a sparse area. But this is our first target system. This is supposed to be... Oh, pull back. Oh. That target system there is where at the first of the... the waypoints are for the trip out to Colonia. The only problem is actually linking into it. So, what I'm going to plan to do, I have gone and bookmarked that. So, we go to yeah. Now. This is the trick. I've now got to go and find where I am. Roughly. Then you kind of got a guesstimate. You see, there's Colonia. I'm going the wrong way. There's Eons. Oh boy. Pull back a little bit there. And we'll zoom in for about here. Okay, that's 1068. That's not too far away. The plotter has about a range of 1,000 light years. So hopefully zoom in a little bit more. About 686, well, okay, let's move back to 700, bit there, go for that one, 800, so, plot the route. Oh, that looks as if we're all over the place. Now, the next thing I really should do is when you look through here, when plotting the route, wasn't there a way to actually... You know, I'm sure there was a way to actually filter out particular stars. Because otherwise I'll be calling up the fuel rats before I know it. Ah, there we are. Apply filter to route. So, we go to star type. Or star class. Oh. Didn't need power play. Here we are. I think we need A, B, F. L, definitely not T's. No. Apply filter to root. Now hopefully this here will then reapply the filter so that I will only have those stars included on the root, which means, of course, I've got a starter. Actually, fuel scoop from. There we have it. Now I'll bookmark that location. And we have 67 jumps. And that's only to go 800 light years. Oh my god. Well, here goes nothing. We're up.
Ship released. Pulsar speed restrictions when passing through the airlock.
Ooh. What the heck was that?
Landing gear retracted.
And we're away. And we're going to, Tukani. So, looking up. Bye-bye, Ridley Scott. Was fantastic to look at that. Ooh, one jump down. 68 to go. Oh, if only there could have been 69. Bill and Ted would be so proud. So, in other news with Elite Dangerous, well, we'll just wait for this jump. Yes, in other news with Elite Dangerous, there is an external project which has started funding on Kickstarter on Monday, and that is another Elite Dangerous role-playing game, the EDRPG. Now, those of you who are aware know that I've worked with Dave Hughes in the past to help out with his Elite Encounters RPG, but a different RPG in charge done by Spidermind Games is going through the Kickstarter process right now. They're after 45 grand to get through its initial stage. They're up to, I think, 72 or 73% of their total after 3 days. So hopefully, not wanting to cause any problems or jinx it, so to speak, I hope that they're going to do it. I mean, I've pledged myself, so we'll just see what happens, I think. There's the fuel scoop. There we go.
Oh,
well, that was nice and easy.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Okay. On to the next one. Ah. So, yeah, The core unit, the core rule books, they are in progress at the moment. We've had a quick look of the sample adventure that you get that they've been Spidermind Games have been handing out. It does seem to be well formatted and well and concise. As at Lay Radio, we are doing some sample games just to see what it's like, of which I think they will be broadcast quite soon. Two new objects. I don't think we'll bother scanning any of that. So, yeah. Now, you can they are planning a few extra things, and they've also got Michael Brooks involved, and he'll be writing one of the source books. Oh, hang on, I'm getting a bit hot here. And Alan Stroud, one of the Elite Dangerous authors, he'll be doing some source books, I think three of them. And I do believe they've employed Josh Attack as well. Now, those of you who might be familiar with the initial starts of Elite Dangerous would be very familiar with his concept artwork, as a lot of the ships that you see in Elite Dangerous come from his artwork. So overall, it does seem to have a high-class pedigree, and it does look like if they do get funded, it will probably be ready Christmas 2017, a long way off. I do know that Elite Encounters, which is Dave Hughes's RPG, and if you look further back in the history for Top Shift, you'll see a couple of demonstrations of that. That should be ready, fingers crossed, mid-July. Personally, I think Elite Dangerous is big enough to be able to handle two RPGs. It'd be quite nice to be able to run them at LaveCon, which is the other thing that I'm here talking about. LaveCon, 25th of 26th of June this year. Same place as last year. You check on the laveradio. I'm running very hot here. Check on the Lave Radio website for more details. Right, how are we doing? 64. Now, one of the things I was going to actually bring up today was that one of the things I want to do when I'm doing this kind of thing is discuss certain things that will happen in Elite Dangerous in the future. I mean, otherwise it's just going to be pretty boring of me jumping from system to system and you guys all going which is not what I want. So I put up on Reddit a couple of days ago a little speculation about space legs, which it's what some of the community call what we think is going to be Season 3. Now, Season 3 is going to be supposed to be getting out of your ship and walking around. That's what the general assumption is, or as I prefer to call it, Elite Feet. So I put up on Reddit some basic speculation of how I would, knowing how Frontier have done things in the past, how they would approach the release of Elite Feet. Well, there's a point, that's one thing. One thing I don't do at the moment is I don't check the system map. Now, at the moment, the system map will have a whole... Whoa! Yes. Oh, there's nothing there. Why to abort? Because otherwise I'm going to overheat and explode before I even get anywhere. Well, look, there's a... unidentified signal source. I don't think I'll go there. Right. Ooh, we're off to an anarchy. Hip. 73,650. So, my theory was, say, in 6 months to a year's time, Season 3 will start. Now, Frontier haven't actually confirmed that getting out and walking around is going to be Season 3. I think a lot of the community have just assumed it would be. So, but working on the assumption that Season 3 is starting with walking around, I've kind of broken it down into four releases, just like it has been with the previous two seasons. So we've got kind of Season 3, which I call just Space Legs, which will allow people to just walk around their ship. But there should be more to it than just that. I was thinking that perhaps at this point, which is walking around the ship, you could also have boarding actions where you could board other people's ships. And then you could either try and take over the opposing person's ship or just trade with them. Which, controversial. So, you know, you could have a bit of a first-person shooter. Now, I do know that one of the reasons why it takes so long for these ships to be created in Elite Dangerous is effectively because they are very meticulous about how the layout, the internal layout of these ships are going to be. Wow, that's quite a system there. First discovered by Trickle. Well done, Trickle. So, let's get some fuel. Got an anarchy here as well. We don't want anarchies. So our next jump is... Eights. Okay. Oh my goodness. What have we got? Okay, let's slow down. Oh dear. Now this is going to be interesting. An NPC. Cobra Mark III harmless. Oh, and he's just going for me already. Wish me luck, folks. This is going to be interesting. I think I'm going to need to stop off at one of these stations to repair anyway. My goodness, he's harmless. Oh, reloading. Got to try and keep behind him. Now if he wasn't... Oh, he's mostly harmless. Oh, and reload. There we go. Oh, it's rattling down those, his shield's back up again. Can definitely tell the AI is a bit rubbish here. Because he is only mostly harmless. He didn't do any special moves or anything like that. Because I don't have a cargo hatch, does this mean that I can't scoop my materials? Yeah, cargo scoop.
Cargo scoop deployed.
Well, let's have a look. Do I have any materials I can? Focus crystals. Focus crystal. Nah, that means that I don't need a fuel, a cargo bay to actually hold these, which is useful. This is one thing about doing a commentary on a Let's Play, is that you lose your train of thought when you're attacked. Of course, because that was an anarchy, I don't get any bonus or any bounty for actually dealing with him. Oh, and of course, I don't have any of these materials yet. Every single material I scoop at the moment is a brand new item, which actually helps towards my elite explorer rating. So, you know. Can't turn this down. That's two new materials discovered. Salvage alloys. It's cold here in the Silver Sidewinder. Something's got up my nose. think I'm, I must be allergic to salvaged alloys. You know what? There. Now, I'm down to 90% of my hull. Do I go into 80s and hope that there's a station there to repair? Ah, what the heck. Right, where is it? And of course it would be the other side of the sun. Oh.
Frameshift drive charging. Here
we go again. Yes, so when, before I was rudely interrupted by that pirate. Oh, which reminds me actually, does that improve? Yes, look, I am 1% more towards novice. Fantastic. So, yes, I'd broken it down into four sections. Obviously, the initial release of space legs. Then you again end up with planet legs. Now, what I thought this could be was where you can not only drive about a planet on an SRV, you can get out the SRV and walk around the planet. There might be stuff you might want to scan. There might be, obviously, running around the ruins with your... hang on. Destination. One of these days. Side. So, obviously, running around planets or ruins or the outside of ports on the planets, that could be gameplay. You could even sort of walk up to one of these outposts and connect to a mission terminal or something like that in order to...
Frameshift drive.
Oh, this one's another anarchy. I'm choosing them now. It's still unknown, so we don't know what we're going to see there. So, if things do go to plan, the next one I think would be sort of like outpost legs. So that is where you would be able to walk around the small outposts that are in space, and also the, you know, the smaller planetary systems.
Ooh,
10 items here. 12 items here. That's quite good going actually. Check the system data, see if there's somewhere I can dock and repair. There is. Now, let's hope that Judson Mine. Repair facilities.
Fuel scooping complete.
Because the real worry is, of course, if I get jumped when I'm 400, 500 light years away from the bubble, I've got no choice but to press on. I don't have anything to repair my hull with or any of my equipment. So, I really am taking my life in my hands when I think about this. That's a Type 7, we're okay for a Type 7. And of course 3.3, which would be the whole season, that would be port legs, that would be walking around the big Coriolis stations, the big Orbis stations. And also, I mean, have you seen the size of the planetary ports? They are phenomenally huge. If you get a chance to visit Sol, I would recommend visit one of the cities on Mercury. It will blow your mind, especially if you're driving around in an SRV. So, as usual, talking too much and loop of shame. So, I must admit, the response I got on Reddit for this was actually very positive. And a bit weird, I must admit. You guys went a little bit mad for the elite feat. So, I mean, just looking down here, we've got... I mean, obviously, Captain Hoyt, he wants space legs to be renamed as elite feat completely. Thank you for that. someone has actually managed. This is Commander Ignatius Riley. Now, Commander Ignatius Riley is, we like him at Live Radio because he does the fantastic fish advert. We play it all the time because it cracks us up. But he's actually done elite feat in elite speak. So L337F337. So well done. I must admit, what is with you guys? You all got a foot fetish or something? Because 15 comments all about feet, elite feet. And of course then spoilt by Eustad, who's there saying, just take a dump in your pants, which for some reason he got fixated about taking a dump in your pants in a marathon. So, as usual, Reddit. Yeah. Oh, goody, here's my docking request. But apart from that light-hearted comment, there was an awful lot of reasoned debate on Reddit. I hear you cry, but no. There were a lot of people saying that they should fix a lot of the broken features in the moment, or the features which they consider broken, rather. To which my point was that wasn't really the question. The question that I was asking was whether or not they felt that, what their opinion about space legs was actually going to be. The point I was trying to make at that point was, well, actually, no, this, assuming we get space legs, it would be, half of those gameplay issues would be resolved that people have trouble with. Whoa, coming in for a crash. There we go.
Warning, landing gear not deployed.
It is deployed. I'm also used to flying something a little bit less nimble, responsive in the engine wise. Come on. Landing gear. That was a bit of a chore. Of course, the one problem that I really do have at the moment is that if I screw up a landing on this, it's hull damage. It's not nothing on these protective bouncy shields. So, refuel all, repair all, restock all. Now that is something that I have completely forgotten about. Because I've equipped myself with multi-cannon. Now, the one thing that multi-cannon's going to need, it's going to need ammo. So that means I'm going to have to stop off every now and again and look through planets and scan planets to find the materials in order to restock my ship. So, this is going to be interesting. I don't think there was any bounties there. No. Nothing to worry about there then. Right. So after that little pit stop, we then go ahead and select Coles Sector 285. Launch. So, yeah, a lot of the... There's a lot of debate of whether or not space legs or elite feet was going to be Season 3. A lot of people seem to be under the impression that the Thargoid or the alien menace is going to take place. It's going to take the place of Season 3. Which, I suppose I can see your point on that. Personally, I was always under the impression that this was going to be season 3. But, you know, if it is going to be too much work, well, we'll just have to wait and see. I mean, it's the Commander Creator, I think, in 2.3 that we're all waiting for now. So, I think it would be nice if you could walk around the bridge. Maybe. But I think that might be asking too much at this particular moment. Which brought me onto a nice discussion with a couple of people about, you know, how multiplayer is probably going to work. And it made me think of the old game Independence War, in the old circles. I mean, we did cover it in Retrolave, and people either really liked it, i.e. me and I think one other person, everybody else hated it because it felt like you were... You had to spend 3 or 4 hours learning how to fly the ship before taking it any further, which was kind of the point, because it had a full Newtonian flight model and you had to learn how to fly the thing, which I really liked because I'm a masochist, I think. Anyway. There they had the flight crew, the bridge crew was a bridge crew of 4. And each of those bridge crew would do a certain function, so you would flip between the 4 stations. And it does occur to me that that is quite similar to what you could do with Elite Dangerous for multi-crew. So for instance, you'd have a pilot commander, who would obviously fly the ship. You would have a gunner, who can obviously take control of the guns independently to the pilot. And then finally, you'd have an engineer who would handle shields, power management, repair duties.
Fuel scooping.
Now, we do know that I think they're going to limit it to 4 players per ship. So the most you're going to have really is maybe 2 gunners, an engineer and a pilot. That is supposed to be able to match 4 other ships of exactly the same caliber. You know, it's supposed to match a wing. So, all I can think of is they must be thinking up some custom modifications for multi-crew. Now, this is a low security world. Does that mean there's actually anybody there? We've done 8 jumps in an hour. Oh, I could have sold my data at that last place. My little rating, my poor little aimless rating up a bit. Next station I see, I will stop off and dump what exploration data I know. Dump that off. I don't think this one's got one. Oh, it's just a sun all by itself. Oh, poor sun. Yeah, I think actually we've now hit into the unknown sectors. This might be it. I might be completely away from the bubble. Oh well, I suppose hang on, I better fuel up a little bit or jumping.
Fuel scooping complete.
Gotta be careful about that heat levels. I'm forgetting this thing just overheats like crazy. I mean, a lot of people, there was speculation about whether or not a 2.4 will even be atmospheric landings or things like that. I mean, David Braben himself said that the atmosphere landing part of the ship of the game was a long way off. Mind you, he did say the same about elite feet, so we'll just have to wait and see. Of course, this is the thing, Frontier keep their cards very close to their chest. Oh. But yeah, it was a fun discussion. A lot of the guys there on Reddit, thank you for taking part in the discussion. It was nice to have a pleasant conversation with people, instead of it all turning into "you suck" and "go play No Man's Sky." No. Although, you know, if it drops in price again, I might give it a try. You're doing a top shift of that. Right. Ooh, 5 astronomical objects already. 17 found. Alright. And this is the problem with this thing. It's because I pressed the Y button too long and then it dropped me out of Super Cruise. But wow, that's an awful lot there. Right. So, what's the next planet? Although, I suppose that's an interesting point. I mean, should I try and find a landable world or a station to dock at in order to, Now look at that. I was completely right. No, there is one economy. I must be right at the edge of the bubble. No, seriously, I must be, because there. Independent dictatorship refinery colony. Let's go there instead. Hopefully, if I go there, we'll have a station I can land at and sell my scan data so far. I just have to refuel up. I mean, there's 57 jumps more to go, so I've done 10 jumps tonight. And that's to get me halfway to, oh, gold. Super Cruise is what I need. Oh, that's good. Fuel scooping. And there's the fuel scoop. I mean, there won't be much data, but it might be enough. Just bump me up a little bit above, towards the next level.
Frameshift drive charging.
That's a bit harsh, that. Now, there is one thing that I think people are missing with Elite Dangerous as far as the walking around ships is concerned. Walking around ships is going to be difficult because there's no gravity. There's only, as far as I'm aware, one ship which has artificial gravity, and that is the Imperial Interdictor Cruiser with one of those big spinny sections at the back. Ever seen anything on a Federal cruiser or any other ship which implies that they have artificial gravity?
Fuel scooping.
Right. Please let there be a base. Something medium security. Think. Well, there seems to be bases here. Of course, those bases won't turn up until I scan the planet. Right then. Well, let's do a bit of scanning, and we might be able to get out in the SRV.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Bye bye, son. Even looking around here, we've got the emergency trolley. That layout, is that the layout supposed to be based on the BBC? I can't remember whether it's that or the one in the Cobra. Probably actually is the one in the Cobra. So we will slow down, we get 7 seconds. There we go. We'll speed up a bit. Try and keep it at 7. Hopefully. Yep. Oh, slow it down a bit more. Bingo. So, is there anything here that we can land on? Beacon. Yes, Beaumont Beacon, that'll do. Although, to tell you the truth, what I should have really done is go to the nav beacon, scanned it, and that would have given me everything for this system. Let's see the other side. Which is something I'm probably going to miss in the next installment. Now, one of the things that I did discover last time was when I docked at one of the outposts. Oh no. An eagle. Novice. Right, okay, we're submitting. See whether or not I can take out a novice. Bear in mind he's in an Eagle, which is a faster and more maneuverable ship and more heavily armed. There he is. And he's wanted, which makes things nice and easy. Wanted from the moment he got me. But, I will say that an eagle falls apart quite easily. There we go. Boom.
Target destroyed.
And what materials are there? Shield emitters. Field emitters sound good. Never know when you might need them. Although, to tell you the truth, I don't know why I'm bothering to actually pick these ones up. Because, there aren't any engineers out where I'm heading. And this is what you need the engineers for. Well, these materials are for the engineers. Okay. And I missed it anyway. Going too fast. You also notice that the target has a time limit, or is going down in hull integrity quite fast. You know what? That's not going to work at all, is it?
Cargo scoop retracted.
Okay. Guns away.
Frameshift drive charging.
Oh. 55% mostly harmless. I like this.
4, 3, 2, 1.
I think we'll call it a night when we land here. So overall, things in Elite Dangerous are moving along quite happily at a pace. There seems to be a few things happening at once, in addition to the usual breed, upgrade, repeat. And of course, I'm on the wrong side of the planet. So I'm hoping that Frontier can keep the intensity up. Hopefully in a couple of weeks or something, something else will happen with the Thargoids. We don't know about any Thargoids. But the aliens, hoping that a breakthrough will happen with either the Rift or the Monoliths or the Guardians themselves. Yeah, the Xenohenge thing, that is now officially called the Guardians. Ooh, going in too fast. Am I going in too fast? I am going in too fast. Oh, it's one of the massive cities! Oh, that's fantastic! I'll be able to show someone. These are huge. This is the equivalent of the planetary equivalent of the Orbis stations. That's amazing. I'm what, 31 kilometers away in it, and you can see it almost perfectly. Oh, transition. There we go. Glide complete. Oh, you can look at the shadows coming in now. Oh my god, I've arrived at Planet Chorley. So I mean, look, I'm just gonna slow this down and just to look about. It's phenomenal. And that is our landing bay down there. You can actually get out your SRV and drive around here if you wanted to. Oh, that's fantastic. Actually just being able to see one of these things before I head away. Descent to flight level 300. Hey, Chuck, thanks. Ta-da. Going off for our bodies. I miss bodies. Proper stuff, that is. For those of you who don't know, it used to be made in a brewery in the centre of Manchester from a natural spring, and since they moved it, it just doesn't taste the same. Oh, hello all! Every time I hear that, I think of Cholton and the Wheelies when I was a little boy. That's almost that's more than 30 years ago. 35 years ago, actually. Feeling old now. Cholton and the Wheelies. Hello, little old lady. Right. Oh, we can claim a bounty. Let's do that. I'll pay for the fuel and the restock anyway. Now that is one of the major things I'm going to have to watch, the ship integrity. Because as that falls, the rest of the internals of your vessel don't work as well. So, that, thank you very much. Right, universal cardiographics. 37 grand in just one go. Wow, both of those for more than 12,000 credits. 10,000 credits each. That'll be quite good. Oh, hasn't registered yet. It'll probably take about 5-10 minutes for that actually to be updated. Or it'll be updated next time. So, thanks for joining me. I will be putting this up as soon as I can. And next stream will be at 11 o'clock on Sunday. Hope to see you then. Thank you and good night.